that job seriously.
Yes, Jack, Ron van den Berg and Eddie Ridderhoff are practicing for the shooting later on in this program in the studio, your studio guest. Okay, guys, let's try. You know what you have to do? Great! Great! Great, yeah. That will work. Okay, you see, Jack, no problem. The shooting with those guys. Great.
Nice practicing of our two studio guests. Here they are, Eddie Ridderhoff and Ron van den Berg, but now in our Sky studio. And they have to do better here to score more points than Brian Roy or Mario Beno, Jacques Zwart. And they have to score better next Sunday. The main game of the Premier Division is Sparta against PSV. And of course we will show that on next Tuesday. But before we're going to shoot with the two guys here in the studio, we take a look at a castle Spangen of Sparta Rotterdam. Here's our Lord, Lord Jan Rietman.
Yes, Jack, and here we are in Rotterdam West. You know, Feyenoord is playing in the south of Rotterdam, and here in Rotterdam West, on Spangen, it's called, there is Sparta playing. It's very old here, but they are trying to rebuild all the houses here. The surrounding from the stadium will be rebuilt, but the stadium will be the same for years and years. In 1888, Sparta is playing cricket and football on Northern Ireland, and that's near the Burgemeester Hofmanplein here in Rotterdam. In 1916, Sparta becomes the Western champion, and for the first time they started to play here on Het Kasteel, the stadium of Sparta in Spangen, Rotterdam. In 1963, the Schietribune is ready. More than 30,000 spectators are allowed to go into the stadium. And then it's 1985. Sparta is fourth in the table in the National League and they are allowed to play UEFA Cup football. First, they beat het HSV and that was a very exciting match. The penalties were stopped by the one and only Mr. Bas van Noordwijk and he's now playing for the FC Utrecht. But injured.
Bas van Noordwijk maakt een einde aan deze wedstrijd.
And now it's time to go into the stadium, Het Kasteel. Time to talk to Mr. Barry Hooks, the trainer coach of Sparta Rotterdam. Well, and inside the stadium, here he is, Mr. Barry Hooks, and I know everything about you because I read this book. That's your book.
Well, it's just come out, Jan, and I'm very pleased with it. It's a sort of first autobiography that's been written about somebody in Holland. The Football International have tried this, and that's the book, and it's...
You're called The Entertrainer.
The Entertrainer, yeah. Through all the things I've done in Holland, in show business, and it's a book about from when I was very young, meeting Alice, and right the way through.
Let's start in the beginning. What did you do before coming to Holland?
Well, I played at West Bromwich Albion, an English club, and then I broke my leg, you can read it here, and then I was transferred to a club called Blauwit in Amsterdam. And from Blauwit I went to a club called Alkmaar. From Alkmaar I got the trainer's job, and then I went through to all the clubs I've trained in Holland.
And then you came for the first time to Sparta. It's a royal club, you can call, because Prince Hendrik was here a couple of times.
Well, he wasn't here when I was here. I must say that when I came to Sparta, they were struggling a bit. And then we went the first year I was here, seventh place. The second year was sixth place. And then we got the fourth place. And that brought us into European football the first time for 14 years.
Yeah, so but then you left.
Yeah, it was...
You brought him, and then bye.
I was sorry to do that, really, you know, because I went to FC Utrecht, and they went into European football, and they did very well. They lost to Moscow, and then the next
third
year...
third round.
Yeah, and then the next year they lost... also got into Europe, getting the fifth place, because the English teams were banned.
Yeah.
That's where they were able to come into European football, and then they lost to Mönchengladbach. And then the third year I was away, they didn't get into it, and I've come back from a second season now. And
What did you do when you left for the first time?
I left to go to Utrecht, and then I went from Utrecht to a club called MVV in the south of Holland, and then I went from MVV to Volendam. I went a bit quick to three clubs.
You did them all, eh?
In 3 years, yeah. And I'm not usually like that. I usually stay at clubs 3-4 years, like Haarlem, I was there for 7 years. And something went. I shouldn't have really left Sparta, but that's the way it goes.
Yeah. A couple of years ago, then when you left Sparta, when you had some problems at MVV, FC Utrecht, there were a lot of guys talking about you going to Feyenoord, a top trainer with a top club.
Well, it depends on many things, you know. The first thing, the directors have got to want you, and, you know, and as you can read in this book, it's I think the show business side of it has spoiled me with singing songs.
You are making records, eh?
I made a few.
Great singer, a great singer. We'll do that on Sky in the future.
Yes, you can go into anything with
it. You made a new record also.
I've got a new record going now. I hope we can over a few weeks sing it for the Sky Channel.
So, no Feyenoord, but you made records. And now, for the second time here with Sparta.
Yeah.
You can work with a lot of talent, Jules Ellerman. What you need is a spits, eh? A striker.
Well, this is very good for Sky Channel because we've just signed a spits.
A new one.
Striker from West
Ham United.
Let
me guess, yeah.
Yeah.
An Englishman.
An Englishman, yeah.
Who is it?
It's Greg Campbell. He's come from West Ham United and he's a very, very young player. He's 22, but he's got an awful lot of potential. And our chief scout, Mr. Sunil, went to watch him against Chelsea, West Ham United against Chelsea. He was very impressed. Came back and we brought him here for a week last week and he did very, very well. And the players, once the players think the world of him, you know, the players were saying, trainer, watch him, you know, you could get... And that's a good sign. So we've just signed him today, and I'm very, very pleased he'll be playing against PSV.
Yeah, I wonder, Greg Campbell, is he familiar to the great Campbell from England?
Greg Norman, you mean, the golfer. No, he's nothing to do with that. But his father was a very famous
footballer.
Yeah,
that's what I mean.
And his father was Bobby Campbell. He used to be manager of Portsmouth, and he was coach at Arsenal. So he comes from a very footballing family. I don't want to say too much, because people will be... expecting it, but he's got to settle down. But he's got an awful lot of potential.
Next weekend, you have to play against PSV. Last season, the first match of the competition.
Well, last season
you were unlucky.
Yeah, we on that goal there. We two minutes before the end, Rudy Gullit just got a tick on, and he scored with 3 minutes to play, and we were winning 1-0. PSV don't come to Sparta, you know,
with a good feel.
No, they're a bit afraid of us. And
you think they are unbeatable?
I don't think so. I think you can beat them. I think you can beat them. I think if things go right, like we played against Sparta against Ajax, and you have a bit of luck, football luck, and everybody's concentrated, like you remember, you can beat a team like that. If you're a bit lucky in the first 15 minutes, you don't get two goals quick against you.
Well, you beat at Ajax this season.
We beat Ajax.
You were unlucky against Feyenoord. And now PSV.
So we're going for the third one now.
Okay. I hope there's a lot of public on the tribune because it's a nice stadium over here.
We've got a new striker. We've got PSV. They go all internationals. They're unbeaten on the top of the league. We've got the knives out. We're going after them. We're going to try and beat them. So it's a big game. It's a big game.
So another scalp. The scalp of Chris Hiddink.
We'll go after the scalp.
From Mr. Berriuk.
Yeah, I hope so. It's got everything to be a big game because we're not going to go in like lambs and say, well, we're afraid of them.
No,
we're going to go and try and beat them.
Okay, good luck.
Thank you.
We will be there with Sky Channel because it's our match of the week. So you can see that on Sky next Tuesday. Let's go to Greg Campbell. Let's see if he's here. As in here on Sky, we can introduce a new player for Sparta, Greg Campbell. You're in Holland now. You played in England?
Yes, I played in England, played for West Ham in England.
But it seems that you got another club in Holland, and now it came out that it's Sparta.
Yes, I think it could be lucky for me as well. Having Mr. Hughes as an English coach for me, it might help iron out a few little problems I might have starting off over here.
You know the Dutch football?
I played over here in a few tournaments. When I was a youngster, I played for West Ham's juniors in the Go Ahead Eagles tournament in Deventer. I've also played in a tournament in Ockenburg when I was an under-18 player for West Ham. And I've had good experiences over here in Holland.
What kind of player you are?
I'm a striker.
Score against PSV next Sunday.
Let's hope so. I hear not too many people have scored against PSV this season.
No. You have a very good goalie.
It'd be nice to break the duck against them, yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
What do you expect from living here in Holland, because it's quite different from England, I think.
You have
to put all things together.
Yeah.
Put it on a boat or a plane.
That's right. I have to bring almost. I've just been speaking to my wife.
She's happy too.
She's happy. Yeah. We've been over here a couple of times now, and I wouldn't be back a third time if I didn't like it. We're going to ask my father-in-law to bring most of my furniture over, I think, and put it in a flat for us or something. But first we have to find a flat to live in.
Okay, now it's good to live in Rotterdam, no problem.
Yes.
See you later on in the program. We have a trick of the week.
Okay, thank you.
So we're back in the studio with our two guests, Eddie Ridderhof and Ron van den Berg from Sparta. Sparta PSV, important, that's Sparta Feyenoord and Sparta Ajax. You play always good against the top teams. Is that normal, Eddie?
Yeah, it's normal that Sparta plays always very good against Ajax, PSV, Feyenoord, and I think this year will be also very important because PSV didn't lost any points until now, and we will try to
win.
Yes, to win.
Why not? Try to win. How strong is Sparta at the moment, Ron?
Now we had a very good start, but then we fell back. And the last three games we had 4 points, and I hope we can beat PSV.
Last year, a draw, 1-1. Rudy Gullit scored.
Yeah, we lead most of the game. We lead it 1-0. And then I believe it was 3 minutes before time. I think there was a corner from the right side, and Gullit didn't touch it, or did it touch, I don't know exactly, but at last it was one against one, so it was a little bit disappointed for us.
Do both of you guys score sometimes? Tell something about your goal.
I remember a goal against Fortuna. It was in Sittard, and it was a very tough game for us, and maybe after 20 minutes we got a penalty. The score was until that moment 0-0, which was very important for us, and I scored 1-0.
A penalty, still it's a goal.
I think if you can keep your nerves down, I think you always have to make a penalty.
He's a cool player. You're sometimes too cool. Although you scored in the European Cup, can you remember?
Yeah, a few years ago it was
before First World War.
Yeah.
Something
We played with Sparta against Jena, and in Jena we played 1-1, and I scored the goal for Sparta, and by that goal we go to the next round.
After that, you went to Groningen. You came back. You're happy to be back in Rotterdam?
Yes, I'm happy to be back.
You just bought, you didn't buy it, but you just got a new player, or bought a new player, Greg Campbell.
Yeah.
Is that a goodie?
I think he can be, if he can play an important role for us, because he is a typical English player, plays in the middle of the center forward, and he can keep the ball, so I think we need someone who does that things for us.
That's going to be the man who breaks the defense next Sunday?
I hope so.
Let's see. You never know. He is tricky. Watch his trick. Here is Greg Campbell, the newcomer in Sparta first team.
Yes, Jack, we are back in the Sparta stadium called De Kasteel, Het Kasteel in Dutch. And with me, Mr. Campbell, we have to do a trick, the trick of the week. What do you think is your best trick?
Oh, I think the trick of the week would be to beat PSV on Sunday, wouldn't it?
Yeah, but that's not too easy, because I already told you they have a good goalie.
Yes,
so
I know.
So you have to try some things. Okay, I'll be the goalie.
Okay.
I think I'm maybe a little better than Mr. Van Breukelen, but okay, you try.
Don't get that jacket dirty.
Okay, no, I'll take him off, no problem. Here, you got a ball?
Okay.
And show us something. Can beat me in this goal, I think Hans van Breukelen will have a very heavy Sunday. So Hans, take care on Sunday, because it's a good striker. Jack, I hope in the studio with the shooting you have a better goalie than I am, because I don't know. The shooting with Jack.
And here's the shooting with Eddie and with Ron. You gonna start?
Yes.
75 points. Brian Roy, Mario Bain, and Shaq Swart. Here is Eddie Riddler. Go ahead. He goes for 35. Richard Witzel last week scored once at 35. And 25.
35 again. Why 35, 25, 35?
A little bit change.
You like that?
Nice for the people.
I don't know. Oh, I was watching 35. Strange way of shooting. Okay, do it again.
Normal way.
Spitty. A little bit, 35. I think Ron goes for a certain goal. What will it be, Ron?
35.
Oh, 35.
How much is it? 17 and a half.
25. Yeah. 35. Watch it. Watch that face. Oh, like that. 35, good.
75?
75, yeah. Ron van den Berg, 35, but one attempt. One more. It was the end of the game because 35 is ruined by you, but you scored once. Eddie, 0 points, 35 points. It's okay. I think PSV will have a tough opponent next Sunday. These two Sparta guys are on sharp. See you after the break.